dear all, you must be wondering where I have been these last few days. I've been laid low with a sprained ankle and am staying in the Royal Hunting Lodge in the Disenchanted Forest. Do carry on with the coronation plans and rest assured I will be back in plenty of time for the big day. Lots of love, Prince Wendell.
Thank goodness for that.
That explains it.
It explains nothing. Why has the prince made no reference to the Troll King crisis?
Well, perhaps he hasn't heard about it. Twisted ankle can be excruciating.
The Troll King has challenged Wendell to face him in combat. Meanwhile, he's been killing Fourth Kingdom citizens, and nothing's being done about it.
We need a plan.
We have a plan. My seating plan. The ceremony is barely 3 weeks away. I need the prince for a fitting, and I need people to at least commit to a basic color scheme.
I'm worried about Wendell. I shall go to the hunting lodge by the fastest steed in the kingdom and tell him of the Troll King's challenge.
Jolly good idea.
One further thing. The queen is still at large. She has spies everywhere. Nothing that is said here must go beyond this room. Agreed?
Agreed.
We must consider military options. Otherwise, we would be perceived as being spineless in Wendell's absence.
Would it help to calm people if we announced...
Summon my huntsman. Doesn't believe my letter. They have sent a man to Wendell's hunting lodge. He must not return.
We'll be done.
You know, if you were kidnapped, it would have been all right. But Virginia, oh, have I lost my one true love?
Oh, please stop with the one true love, all right? You're some grubby ex-con. You've had nothing but trouble since we met you.
Don't talk to me like that. I'll bite you in a minute. You want to dance with me because I've had just about enough, all right?
I'm not... Shh, listen.
Halt! Who approaches?
Forgive us, noble woodsman, but have you seen a gorgeous girl with very long hair?
I haven't seen anything. I'm blind.
A blind woodsman?
Have you ever seen a tree move?
Tony, what? Look at his axe. Is that axe by any remote chance the magic axe that cuts through anything?
Could be.
Oh, how much do you want for it?
Yeah, how much?
Oh, you can have my magic axe, if you can guess my name. But your friend must kneel by this block, and if you haven't found my name out by the time I've chopped all these logs into firewood, I will have his head.
What is it with you people? What kind of twisted upbringing did you have? You know, why can't you just say, oh, that'll be 100 gold coins? Why does it always have to be? No, not unless you lay a magic egg or count the hairs on a giant's ass.
You want the axe or don't you?
No, let's just carry on looking for Virginia.
Oh!
What?
I know this. It's all right. We accept.
Well, no, don't accept on my behalf.
No, no, it's fine.
No, it's okay.
It's okay. I swear. It's okay.
Very well. Lay your head on the block. All your friend guesses.
But just for Virginia?
Yes. Don't worry.
Okay.
Just to make you secure.
I know this. Don't worry about it at all. All right. Mister, I don't have to look, but I can chop wood. Your name is Rumpelstiltskin. No! I said Rumpelstiltskin.
His name? Guess again.
Rumpelstiltskin Jr. Rumpelstiltskin the Fourth.
No.
Does it have a rumple in it?
Please let me go. I'm not involved in this.
Where's the dog?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't make me ask again.
I think he's dead.
I think you're lying. And you're not lying. Is he hurt? You were dragging something on wheels. Yet the tracks were too deep for the weight of just the dog. But what about the others? They come looking for you.
They don't give a damn about me.
So they will come. Do they have any weapons?
Yes.
No weapons.
Tom. Dick. Van Dyke.
Cold.
Elvis. Frankie. John, Paul, George, Ringo.
Ringo? Colder.
Way off.
Well, come on, look. Just give me a clue. Yeah, what kind of fun could it be just to kill it?
Yeah.
Quite a lot of fun, actually. In fact, you could say that is the reason for my existence.
I was born here in this forest. When I first saw the queen, I was still a forester. She came to my village. She stopped her hunting party to water the horses. Then she called me forward and showed me this. She said, when this crossbow is fired, the bolt will not stop until it hits the heart of a living being. It cannot miss. So I said, what must I do to win this magic crossbow? And she said, just close your eyes, fire wherever you wish, and it'll be yours. So I did. The bolt left the bow like gossamer. It sped a mile through the trees, then killed a child who was playing. I remember the queen's face as I pulled the bolt from my son's heart. And she said, you will be my huntsman. So you understand, the hunt is my purpose and only pleasure. I have no interest in mercy.
No! Well, how do we know you're not lying about your name?
Hey, that's right. Yeah. I could have said it already.
Yeah. You can guess my name. By a long way.
Long way.
My name is in my hat. I may be blind, but my hearing is excellent. Move any closer, and I chop your friend's head off.
You're a sick pervert, huh?
Yeah, sick pervert.
You've done this before, haven't you? Yeah.
Hundreds of times.
And approximately, what was the percentage of correct guesses?
No one has ever guessed.
Oh!
Your Majesty,
are you there?
Hello? Anyone there? Prince Wendell?
That made you kill your own son.
It was my destiny to kill my son. It was her destiny to ask me.
You're crazy. Everybody in this whole place is crazy!
Whatever is meant to happen will happen no matter what we do. It is my destiny to kill you now. Who are you?
I'm nobody. I swear I'm nobody.
We will continue our discussion later.
The Mad Axeman.
I told you, you'd never guess.
Hurry up. Name. It's forming in my mind. Just a second. It's coming.
Oh. Too late. Now I will have your friend's head.
Just a minute, Juliet!
Please go and find my father and Wolf and tell them where I am. Tell them to come and get me.
Who would have thought it? Juliet the X-Man.
Yeah, well, you know what? Is it any wonder he turned into a sick sadist?
You down there.
It's another one of those birds.
I know where Virginia is.
Okay. Where?
She is in a tree that is not a tree. In a place that is not a place.
All right, hold. Can we just stop with the rhyming crap? Take us there.
Come on!
She's inside this tree. Hide!
Wait a minute, inside a tree? How could she be inside a tree?
Virginia! Virginia, are you up there?
How do we get in?
There's a door.
A door?
A door.
Where? I don't see a door. There's no door. There's definitely no door.
Oh, if he's concealed it with magic, it could take weeks to open.
Why can't you just come down and let us in from the inside?
Well, he's chained me up. I can't. Can't you climb up the tree?
Well, there are no footholds.
Well, get a ladder or something.
Where am I going to get a ladder? Hold on a second. If this is a magic axe, maybe I can chop the tree down.
Virginia, can I ask you a question?
What?
How long is your hair now?
Longer than ever. It's... No. No.
That's a great idea.
No!
I've always wanted to say this. Love of my life, let down your lustrous locks. Look out below! Close your eyes!
What is it?
Dandruff!
I do not have Ow!
Oh, some people can't take a joke. What a moment in my life. My second opportunity to save you. My story will be immortalized in song. There's no question of that. I found another gray one! Ta-da!
Thank you.
careful you don't trip over your hair. Stay back, Virginia. Stay back!
It's a bad place. Let's go.
Good idea.
Oh, wait. We can't just leave him like this.
You're right. Give me the axe. I'll do it.
Wait, we can't kill him.
Of course we can. He'd kill us.
No, that's not the point. He's helpless.
Exactly why we should kill him now.
Whoa, no.
He's gonna come after us.
I don't care. We're not killing him.
You're gonna regret this moment. Come on.
Hey, boy. Welcome back. Time for walkies. Oh, hey. How did the haircut go?
Well, I think I might have overdone the axe trim a little.
Well, I don't...
What? You just don't say a word.
Oh, my...
You are inviting trouble.
I'll tell you something. War is great fun when there's no enemy.
You're very stupid, even for a troll. Wendell's kingdom borders all the others. They will not let it fall without a fight. The other kingdoms will send in troops and crush you!
Then I'll kill them all. I'm not scared of anybody.
Listen to me. I will give you everything you desire, but you must leave Beantown. Now!
Beantown's all news. We've got control of every village 20 miles from here. And it's not stopping there. I'm taking my half of the kingdom right now. Want to make something of it?
I don't believe it.
That's Acorn's wagon. That's it. That's him.
We're going home. Bring Prince!
Okay. You talk.
Oh, hi, Acorn.
Hi.
Remember me?
Anthony. You got out of prison. How, unlikely.
Where's our mirror?
Mirror?
It belongs to us.
Was it valuable, then?
No, it's worthless.
You've come an awful long way to get back a worthless mirror.
It's a magic mirror. We traveled here through it, and we've been trapped in this world ever since. Look, all we want to do is go home. We won't take the mirror, okay? We'll just use it to go home, and then you can do whatever you want with it.
I'm moved by what you say.
Then please, let us go home.
But I don't have it anymore. I'm afraid I swapped it with someone in the village, well, not half an hour ago.
Swapped it? Swapped it for what?
Wolf.
simply ignore me?
Changed. I am no longer under your influence. You cannot touch me.
Oh, really? It's a full moon tonight. Your blood is already hot. You are a wolf. What will you do when a wild moon calls you? What will you do then for your new friends?
I don't think we should go into this village.
This is where Acorn said the mirror was.
A wolf goes by his instincts, and I don't like it. I mean, this is farming land, and farmers don't like wolfies. Puff, puff. No siree. Why don't we stop for breakfast and think about what to do?
You already had breakfast.
Well, then I want another breakfast. I mean, what are you, my mother? You tell me when I can eat and not? Why don't you just draw up a list of things I can and can't do?
We're going into the village, end of discussion. You can do what you like.
Junior, please forgive me. I didn't mean to be so rude. It's just that my cycle is coming on. You see, once a month I get very irrational and angry, and I just want to pick a fight with anyone who comes near me.
Sounds familiar.
But I'll be perfectly all right if you just keep me away from temptation.
You know, I get like that too sometimes, actually, but...
Oh! Oh. Look at those sheep. Drops. This shouldn't be allowed.
Morning. My name's Sally Peep. I'm a shepherdess.
There's no question about that.
My, what hairy strong arms you've got. If my door wasn't locked,
yeah.
I'd be scared you'd come into my house and huff and puff and blow all my clothes off.
Where do you live, Sally?
Okay, let's go.
Welcome one and all to the second day of the Little Lamb Village Annual Competition. Well, it's a new day today and a new competition. The best radish in the village. Mrs. Morris, these radishes are beautiful. I'll give them 9 out of 10. But the peeps, these radishes, and bless me, they've done it again. They're out of this world. I got to give them 10 out of 10. Come on, Peter Grocer, come up and get your 9th award today.
Found it. The peeps have done it again. They're just best at everything.
Ladies and gentlemen, in an hour's time, I'll announce the winner of best cheese in the village.
Excuse me. Can you tell me who's in charge around here?
I am the village idiot, and I am in charge of the wishing well.
We have magnets in our pockets. How do we attract people like this?
It's a nice dog you got there. He reminds me of someone.
What's that for?
That's the village's present for Prince Wendell. It's to be his coronation pope.
I hope he likes it.
Aren't you going to make a wish, then? It's very bad luck to pass without making a wish.
That's money we shouldn't be wasting.
Oh, you are so prim. But my wish will change all of that.
It don't work.
What?
used to be a real magic wishing well. And folks, they traveled from all over the kingdoms to have things blessed in it. That's all dried up now. It hasn't flowed for years. I have made it my life's work.
As fascinating as your story is, what we're actually looking for is a mirror,
but so big, black. We were told that someone bought it off of Acorn the Dwarf.
Mm-hmm. I have made it my life's work to wait by this well until it fills up again. What do you think of that, eh?
It's no use. The man is a complete idiot.
If only. And my father. He was a complete idiot. I'm still a half-wit.
Everywhere is full, what with the annual village competition. But you can stay here if you like. Might not be posh like what you're used to.
Oh. It stinks.
It's great, thank you. By the way, do you know of anybody that's bought a mirror from a traveling trader recently?
Oh. Ah. You want to talk to the local judge. He bought a load of things off that dwarf. Prizes for the competition. You'll find him in the inn over the road. They do lovely food there, too. Well, that's the understatement of the year. Thanks.
Oh, cramps! I need to go to bed. I need to lie down immediately. I need a hot rabbit to stroke to comfort me. A long-eared rabbit is best. Now. Right now.
You know, you're running a terrible temperature.
They look so innocent, don't they? But they're not. Provocative, teasing little fluffballs. Just look at her beady little eyes. She knows exactly what she's doing. Don't you?
You just feel really hot.
Stop fussing over me! You're not my mother. Stop mothering and smothering and cupboard loving everybody like a little dwarf housewife. Go out, leave me alone.
Hey, what are you talking to my daughter like that for, right? I'm not gonna take that cut. Let's go see what that is.
You stay with me.
That's the place for us.
Oh. These potatoes.
Did you try the squash?
It's absolutely incredible.
Oh, no.
That's it. Junior, look, tomorrow's competition.
Oh, my God, Dad, look. The mirror is one of the prizes. Sheep and shepherdess competition.
We've got to talk to the judge.
I know.
Oh.
There we are, my dears.
Oh, boy.
Judge about?
The judge will be in for his dinner 8:00 on the dot. There's some more lovely vegetables for you.
You just keep it coming. Good. This is incredible. Mm. And this cider, I don't even like cider. I've had 5 pints.
That cider comes from young Colin Peep's apples. And the lamb was reared by my brother, Larry Peep. Everything you're eating comes from us Peeps. Best farming family in the whole of the 9 kingdoms, if I say it myself.
Well, you go right ahead and say it. What is your secret?
Oh, I suppose we're just good farmers.
Oh.
Start without me, why don't you?
Shouldn't you be in bed?
Bed? Oh, no, I feel bounding with energy. I feel full of life.
Where's the rabbit?
What rabbit's that?
The one I gave you to cuddle.
Goodness me.
I think she must have hopped away.
You've got an appetite like a wolf, you are. Oh, by the way, folks, Judge has just walked in if you want to talk to him.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
So, you can see, sir, that in a way, this mirror really is actually ours.
Yeah. No, it's not. I bought that fair and square. I buy a whole batch of things every year for the village prizes.
Right. You know, Your Honor, I know how these things usually work, so, how about I slip you a few gold coins?
I'm a judge. I don't like people trying to bribe me. No, not another word, or I'll have you thrown out of the village.
Now is the month of Maying when merry lambs are playing. For the lady, for the lady, for the lady, oh, each with his morning lass.
You're new, aren't you?
Yeah.
I can't get these sherbet dips undone. Could you help me, mister?
Well, I,
Yeah, what is your name?
Wolfson.
Wolfson?
Warren Wolfson.
It's my 18th birthday today.
Bet you can't guess what's going to happen to me tonight.
Is it the bumps?
What's that sticking out the back of your trousers? Down there at the back. It's quite a bulge.
I must get going. I think I left a chop on my plate.
Outsiders mess with pig girls. You understand?
What are you doing around here anyway, Mr. Wolfson?
Well, let's take him back.
Excuse me, what are you doing to my husband?
Your husband?
Yes, he's not at all well today, and I must take him home right now. Thanks. Good night.
Good night.
Excuse me. Oh, Virginia, when you said I was your husband, I went all hard and soft at the same time.
I only said that to get you out of here. Come on.
Virginia, I feel so alive. I can see everything for miles. Oh, look at the moon. Doesn't it just want to make you howl? It's so beautiful.
Not really.
Was obsessed with the moon. She used to drag us all out just to watch it when we were cubs. Shepherdess makes quite a mess, but little lambs are lovely. The moon makes me hungry for everything.
Time to go to sleep.
Good night, Ed. Night.
Not bad, please. What? That cider for something. 10 pints. Hey, want to go for walkies?
Look, yes, all right, I feel guilty about what has happened to you. All right? But if I got you into this mess, then I'll get you out. Okay? Hey.
Girl, then. Why do you think everything the peeps make tastes so good, Sally Shepherdess?
I don't want you to know. Used to be that there was a magic well in town, but well's dried up. Everyone knows that.
Do they know? Well, since you're 18, I'll let you into the family secret. Go on, boys. We
reason there's no more magic water in the village well is because me and my brother died for it in the stream 40 years ago. The Peeps have all the magic now. Let's have a look at your sheep. Ugly bugger, isn't he? Can't see him winning you the lovely shepherdess competition.
What do you wash in my magic waters?
Fill the sheep with your goodness and life. Throat. Grandchild or no grandchild?
Do you have any idea what you do to me? You will never know love like mine. I am your mate for life.
Wolf, you don't even know what you're saying. I know you're
a little... Oh, you know, do you? You know everything. Your little Miss Perfect sticks up her hand and can answer every question but knows nothing. You're pretending to live, Virginia. You're doing everything but actually living. You're driving me crazy!
Stop bullying me! I don't like it! Now go to bed! Now!
Or what? Will you scream? That's what most people do when they see a wolf. They scream, scream, and scream! What are you gonna do, stick it in me? That's what everybody does when there's a wolf around. They stick it, and they stab it, and they smoke it out! Oh, they burned my parents good. Oh, yes! The good people, the nice farmers. He made a great big fire and burnt them both.
Hey, you're never gonna guess what I found. I know why the Peeps win everything.
Well, he looks better. Fineness, fineness, fineness. Now she hates you. Oh, now she hates you. Oh, because you're an animal. Oh, and you deserve it, you're nasty. Nasty animal! Oh, nasty, nasty animal! Animal!
Who are your companions?
I'm not telling you anything about her!
Huh? What's she like? Is she tasty?
You're evil. Stay away from me!
Look at the moon. And then tell me what you'd really like to do to her. And let the wolf out.
Scare. It took me almost 3 hours to catch it.
Why have you stolen a sheep?
For the competition, the beautiful sheep and shepherdess competition. Yes, yes, yes. How else are we going to get our hands on that mirror?
I am not a shepherdess. I'm a waitress. I don't know anything about sheep.
You don't have to. That's the beauty of my plan.
Well, this sheep sucks. This isn't going to win anything. It looks like it's about to die.
Well, it won't once it has a trip down the magic wishing well. All right, listen, you get busy making your costume. I'm going to go get it dipped.
My costume?
What? Yeah, yeah, look. Who would have ever thought these used to be curtains? Now, come on, hurry up and watch Prince.
I can't even remember what I've done. You better tie me up. That way I can't escape.
try and tie you up.
Tie me up! Stop me escaping! Which part don't you understand?
Right.
Tighter. 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 If I struggle, I can get free. It's tighter.
What's the worst thing you've ever done?
Tighter. Or I'll eat you up.
Chicken massacre this morning. Oh, we're bringing forward the beautiful shepherdess competition, the prize for which is a trophy and this lovely old mirror.
I want the same as you did for the peeps. I want a beautiful sheep.
Now it's time for the Well of Fortune.
Now we've got three contestants. Good gracious me. Well, the more the merrier, I say. Where's your sheep, miss?
Oh, he's on his way.
She has got one.
I do, too. He's just in the barn.
Well, go and fetch him, girl. And smartish, too, else I shall have to disqualify you. Now, to start the competition, I'm going to ask all entrants, as is the age-old custom, to sing their favorite sheep song. Young Mary Ramley, will you start us off?
Baba Black Sheep, have you any wool?
Oh, hey, hey!
Dad, what the hell is that?
This is a Mira-winning sheep, is what it is.
Oh, my God, Dad, what sheep songs do you know?
Baba Black Sheep.
No, she's already doing that.
Then, I don't know, we'll just pick any song. Just put sheep words to it.
I can't do this. There is no way I'm going to win this thing.
Virginia, listen to your father. If you ever want to go home again, do what you need to do to win this competition.
Ah! Little Bo Peep has lost her sheep and doesn't know where to find.
come alone, and they'll come home, wagging their tails behind them.
And now, contestant number three!
Buddy, you're a lamb, make a big bleat. Playing in the field's gonna be a big ram someday. You got wool on your face, your big disgrace. Waving your fleece all over the place, singing, we will, we will shear you. Sing it! Buddy, are you young? You look at you playing in the fields. Gonna be a big round spot. You got wool on your face, your big disgrace. Waving your face all over the place. Sing it, we will shear you.
Serene. I am very, very serene. I am very, very serenely hungry.
Three beautiful girls and three beautiful lambs. This is the hardest competition to judge so far by a long chalk. I give Mary 8 out of 10 and a well-earned third place. Both these lambs are so beautiful. How do I make a decision? I'm gonna give Sally Peep 10 out of 10. But then, I also have to give Virginia Lewis 10 out of 10 as well.
A tie? You can't have a tie. Someone has to win.
I have to win. Peeps always win. How about if you get a trophy and I get the mirror?
They're both mine. She shouldn't even be allowed to take part.
Why are you giving an outsider 10 out of 10?
She's a dirty cheat. Give the prize to my girl.
Back off.
Back off, I said. Now look. This is a shepherdess competition. We'll set up an obstacle course, and whoever guides a sheep into the pen in the shortest time is the winner. Using only sheep dogs and commands. Sound fair enough?
Oh, yeah, all right.
No, I don't have a sheepdog.
Expect I'll win then, won't I?
Damn, where am I going to find a sheepdog?
Excuse me?
Just be quiet, please, all right? I'm trying to think here.
You've got a dog.
I don't have a... That dog. You know what? I don't know if you've noticed, but that dog... No trouble at all. That's it.
You're an absolute genius.
Stop! Stop! Magic wishing well. Please use your magic, whatever, water, to bring back to life this poor dog trapped in a gold body.
Oh, no, not you again.
Girl stands this end of the village and can only use her shepherding skills with her dog. Are you ready, Sally? Starting now!
God, please, let one thing have gone right.
Oh, no. Did it work? What?
Yes!
Oh, 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 look, look, Fritz, Fritz, fetch.
Turn me into gold?
I didn't mean it. It was a heat of the moment kind of thing. I was trying to protect you from those trolls.
Oh, you really are the most incompetent manservant I've ever had. You are a complete imbecile. What are you?
Listen, all right, I really need your help here, okay?
Time starts now!
Come on, Lamb! Come on, Lammy! Come on! Come on! Come on!
Sully is the winner.
Coming up to 50.
Come along, Pinky. Hurry up. That's it. Stupid little sheep. Hurry up.
Hurry, he comes off. Go, Prince, go.
Count to 70.
Hurry up, or I'll bite you. Get in that pen, you disgusting little woolly jumper.
Count of 80. One, two, three. Virginia the Shepherd is this winner!
No! No! No!
I never thought I'd see the day when a peep got beat.
Come on, get your prize, lad.
Thank you very, very much. It was a team effort. No one person could do it. Bye-bye.
Weeks must have got to our well somehow. It's the only explanation.
You've made me look a fool in front of the whole village. I'm gonna make you suffer for this, Wolf.
It's not showing our world.
I don't know.
I was talking to Prince.
Because it's not turned on. There's probably a secret catch somewhere.
He said it's probably not turned on. Well, how did you get through it in the first place?
I fell on it. It can't be that hard to find.
I don't...
What's this? It's Central Park.
That's Woven Ring.
Immediately, or you will be overrun and we will lose this kingdom! Do you understand?
I'm taking the kingdom! Then I'm coming for you, you evil pig!
Behold the Troll King's latest advance. He's ravaging the kingdom.
It looks like some awful disease.
Surely the trolls are not strong enough to
to seize the entire kingdom?
Well, who will stop them?
If no one else will say it, then I will. Where is Wendell in our hour of need? Where is he? He was supposed to be performing prearranged acts of bravery before his coronation. And now there's a real crisis. He's just run away. He's not fit to be king. Write that down. Put it down. Put it down!
Sirs, forgive me. I have the most dreadful news.
What is it?
Viscount Lansky's horse has returned from the great forest, riderless.
Gentlemen, we have run out of options. We must accept military assistance from the First and Ninth Kingdoms to protect our people. The price of their aid, however, is indeed high. The Fourth Kingdom will be divided into quarters and run by the Council of the Nine Kingdoms in perpetuity, and Wendell will forego any chance of ever taking the throne.
No! No! I will not accept it! I've been planning this coronation for 3.5 years!
Oh, forget the coronation, Lord Rupert! We must sign away sovereignty or lose everything.
Virginia, it's been a terrible mistake.
Look, Wolf, we're going home.
Oh, Bob, you can't!
Look, we don't belong here.
No.
And whatever mess you've gotten yourself into, it has nothing to do with us. Please don't cry. Look, nothing you can say is ever going to change my mind.
Oh, that's home, Prince.
Well, it's not home for me, Tony. And you can't possibly think of going home while you remain my manservant.
All right, let's get something straight, your royal dogness. I am not your manservant. Aha. So did you break the news to him?
Yes. Well, sort of.
What sort of?
Sort of agreed to represent him.
Virginia!
I don't think he killed anybody.
That's what you want to think. There's a dead girl out there. It could have been you. He is a wolf. That's what wolves do.
That's the first intelligent thing you've said, Anthony.
Look, we have the mirror. We can go home anytime.
Right, so let's go right now. Let's go right this minute before we turn into giant pigs or trampled by goblins or whatever's next in this madhouse.
I am not going anywhere until I try to help him.
How? Help me hide this thing under the straw in the wagon. You never used to be this obstinate, you know? That's something he's taught you.
Well, somebody had to, didn't they?
What are you wearing?
I had no choice. You have to.
You know, Virginia, you don't know anything about the laws around here. As a matter of fact, you don't know anything about law at all. Maybe I should have represented him.
Excuse me, who got you out of the parking tickets? Who took the Polaroid of the broken meter?
Virginia, this is a murder case.
Justice is universal.
It's no good. It's no good. We've lost already, my creamy counsel. The local jury is certain to be biased against me.
Now that is what I don't want to hear. Negative thinking. Any jury can be swayed. All you need is a... Oh, my God.
Judge.
It gives me no pleasure to sentence this wolf to death.
terrible crime.
Objection, Your Honor. We haven't heard any evidence yet.
Oh. All right, we're, move it along, nice and brisk, eh?
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, ewes and rams, before you leave this courtroom today, I will not only have proved my client's innocence beyond any reasonable doubt, ow, but also unmasked the real killer.
Just a pot of lemon tea and a slice of Rosy Peeps' ginger cake. Thank you.
Look at this poor man before you. Is he a wolf? No. But he is a stranger. And stranger equals wolf. And wolf equals killer. Is that what we're saying?
Very well put. Now to the sentencing.
Your Honor, I'm only just beginning. I would like to call my first witness. Wilfred Peep. You saw my client running away from the scene of the crime. Is that right?
Clear as daylight. It was him.
If you can read this.
Of course I can. It says, no trespassing according to...
Thank you. I wonder, Mr. Peep, if you can read it now. At the same distance you say you clearly saw my client running away from the murder scene.
According to Little Lamb Village Council ruling number 714B and bylaw 21A.
No further questions, thank you.
We've got to do something to help him.
He's a wolf. What do you expect? He's only done exactly what I said he'd do all along.
Well, Virginia believes in him, and I believe in Virginia.
Nothing you can say will make me help him.
You want to eat tonight?
Miss Peep, what is your profession?
I'm a shepherdess.
Oh, shepherdess? Or temptress?
Oh, yeah, temptress. She's
I'm a good girl. That wolf came up to us girls, and he kept trying to touch us and show us his tail.
Oh, that's a lie! They provoked me.
Provoked you to what?
Provoked me to nothing.
But they sure were trying.
Suggest that you and Sally Peep were the easiest shepherdesses in town.
Are you suggesting that an innocent young girl from this village might kiss a man before she's married?
Well, a bit more than that, Your Honor.
Don't you try my patience. You are just this far from being thrown on the bonfire with that filthy, murdering wolf.
What can you smell?
Your body odor.
Go on, you haven't even tried. Go on, see what you can smell.
Why don't you get down on all fours and see what you can smell? It's mainly feet and excrement at ground level. Had that ever occurred to you?
Can you pick up a scent?
There's hundreds of scents.
Well, yes, but only a great hunting prince like yourself could distinguish that special scent we're looking for.
Correct.
I got it. Let's go.
How would you describe Sally Peep?
Objection!
Sally? Very cute. Oh, succulent. Nice girl. A very tasty little birdie. A new mistake.
Nice enough to eat.
Oh, yes! No. No, I didn't mean that.
She was asking for it. Is that what you're saying?
Begging for it. I mean, she was gagging for it. No. I just meant that some of these girls are very provocative. They know that a wolf, well, it's like thrusting a steak in front of a starving man.
Is it indeed?
Oh, no, I didn't mean that either. See, I'm twisting everything I'm saying.
He's suffering from post-menstrual tension, Your Honor.
Post-menstrual tension? Whatever it is.
The night before the murder, there was a hen house homicide resulting in the death of 10 chickens. Anything to do with you?
No, sir.
You didn't kill those chickens.
No, sir.
You didn't go near the hen house.
Absolutely not, sir.
Then how do you explain this? That is a piece of your shirt. Recovered from inside the Peeps' chicken coop.
Oh, the chickens! Let me think. Yes, yes. I might have eaten all the chickens.
And then you killed Sally Pete.
Oh, a couple of drumsticks doesn't make me a killer. I had chicken for dinner, I admit it. But I didn't touch no girl, I swear.
Then why did you lie?
Yes, why did you lie?
Because if I said yes to the chickens, then you're going to think I wolfed down the girl as well.
That is exactly what we think.
But I didn't do it. I didn't do it, Virginia.
Of course you didn't. Didn't kill Sally Peep. Then who did?
Who did?
I hear myself asking. Myself? Because the time has come for me to point the finger at the real killer. Because last night there was another man walking around dressed as a wolf. Yes! The man in the wolf mask is the real killer! And that murdering piece of filth is the one that should be on this witness stand now!
The honor of playing the wolf in the annual fair has always gone to an unimpeachable member of our society.
I don't care. Bring the sleaze bag in. Let me cross-examine him, and I guarantee we'll have our murderer.
And when that honor was bestowed on me last week, I was only too happy to accept.
I'm most dreadfully sorry, Your Honor.
The Peep's barn.
I've been here, all right? I know about the well.
This is where she came from. She was here just before she was murdered. I can smell her here.
Members of the jury, you have heard the evidence, most of it quite ridiculous.
Some of it.
Now, those who believe him innocent all go into the left-hand pit. Those who know him to be guilty go into the right-hand pit.
The right-hand pen is full of food.
It's full of food. A girl dead, a wolf burns!
So what if this is where Sally came from? I don't know what you expect to find. The well. Somebody's destroyed the magic well. Who would...
Shh! I'm getting a new scent. I think there's something important here.
By a unanimous verdict, I pronounce you guilty of murder,
No!
I sentence you to be burned at the stake. Let's do it right away before the marvelous marrow contest.
And I can prove it.
I'll say anything.
The Peep family has cheated you for years. Like they have their own magic well and have stopped the rest of you from getting any of the water. When Sally Peep lost the competition, she wrecked your well, didn't she, Wilfred? You found out what she did, you followed her up into the field, and you killed her, didn't you?
I don't know what you're talking about. We don't have no magic well.
What do you think?
They've won the competitions year after year. Why do you think their food tastes so much better than yours?
I believe him! You Petes have cheated us for too long!
Oh, where's the proof to any of this? Prove that I killed Sally.
Yes, go on,
that's
prove
right,
it.
Prove it.
Where's your coat, Wilfred? The one you were wearing last night.
He's got Will's coat.
Blood! Oh, my God, it's blood.
Poor Sally, she wasn't yelling Wolf at all, was she, Wilfred? She was screaming your name.
Wilf! Wilf!
No! She'd ruined the well. Dirty little vixen.
What?
It destroyed all of us!
You killed our Sally!
Thank you enough. You saved my bacon. Oh, thanks, old chap. Oh, I owe you a very big bone.
I'm actually disgusted that you're still with us. You repulse me. Why did I have to save your life?
Oh, yes. From now on, we are friends for life. And as for you, Virginia, what a courtroom drama.
So, are you cured now?
Oh, completely. Back to my old self.
Yeah.
I can't remember much about it, to tell you the truth. But I do remember that you and Tony both laid down your lives for
me.
It was the most amazing thing, so dramatic.
Well, what happened to the wagon?
And our mirror?
Oh, my son, John. He's just taken his pigs to market. Left a couple of hours ago.
Which way and how far? Well, it's not a journey you'd want to make on foot.
Bye-bye. Did you enjoy your stay in our village?
Not exactly.
Wish I could remember who that dog reminds me of.
Let me make a suggestion. Prince Wendell, your ruler.
Prince Wendell? Don't be so daft. No, it was a puppy I once knew called Mr. Fleas.
Ah, splendid. Mr. Fleas. Anthony, can we leave this village? One idiot in our group is quite enough.
Let's go.
Aren't you going to make a wish, then?
Why don't you make it for us?
Bye. It sounds like our well's getting some water back in it. Oh, joy! Oh, yay! Oh, yay! The water's back on!
Ask yourself these questions. Do you frequently conceal your emotions? Do you feel like you do everything for other people and then resent it?
Every day, in every way, I am becoming a new and better man.
I'm on the final page of the final chapter of my final book. I now totally understand women, top to bottom. I have perfected a technique of not looking at her all the time. It's very difficult, but I think I've succeeded.
I am listening to my emotions, and I am at one with myself.
Hang on, I haven't finished that page yet. Turn back.
I've managed to stop my tongue from lolling when she arouses me. I've transformed myself into a new man, and soon she will be mine.
Where exactly are we?
We have entered the most romantic town in the whole of the Nine Kingdoms, the kissing town where everyone falls in love. Truly, fate has led us here.
Dream on.
You'll see.
Yeah, well, we didn't come here for that. We came for the mirror, right?
Hello, I've been looking for you all day. I can see love and fortune coming your way.
Oh, it's slice the fruitcake time again.
Dad. Great romance, great wealth before this very night is out.
Ah, which one of us makes the money?
Your aura is cloudy. Just give me a couple of coins.
A couple? Oh, it's the old cloudy aura bit. What are you doing? You are such a soft touch.
Yes.
Thank
soft,
you very much.
Sensuous, creamy touch.
Now, if you look over there, you might find what you're looking for. Goodbye.
Wait, look, okay. That's the pig wagon, the one the mirror was in. It was, wasn't it?
How did she know that?
Yeah, come on, come on, come on. Oh, is this yours? Where's our mirror?
I didn't know it was yours.
No, did I?
Where is it?
You wouldn't want it now anyway. It's covered in pig swill.
Where is it?
I don't rightly know.
What?
Fella gave me 5 coppers for it this morning.
5 coppers? What fella?
I don't know.
Passing through with a wheelbarrow full of bric-a-brac. Probably come from the antiques market.
You'll never find it now, Anthony.
Would not. This place is full of old things. You'd do best to spit up.
Yeah.
Shame you won't have any time for romance, though.
Bric-a-brac. Bric-a-brac.
Something I'll tell you, your trouble is that you've not had to do a hard day's work your entire life.
What would you know about the suffering of royalty? You seem to have been some kind of cleaner in your world.
Yeah. What's wrong with that, all right? Nothing shameful about cleaning. And I had money once, you know that? I was rich.
You? Rich?
Yes. I had a thriving plastics business. I was making 55 grand a year when I was 21 years old.
Ah, so let me guess. You lost it all.
No, I just kind of overstretched myself. I put all my money into an idea that just didn't pan out.
And what was that?
Bouncy castles. We had the Robin and Maid Marian, the Jolly Jester, the Haunted Castle. You know, we had the Cowboy and Indian Bouncer, one of our most popular items. And then the Zigzag Bounce. Our motto was, put the bounce back in your life.
Oh, please stop, Anthony. Oh, no. It can't be.
The trolls. Not a very attractive work, I'll grant you, but full of vitality and life. Frozen rage.
Does it tickle your fancy?
Not even a little bit. Actually, though, I am looking for a mirror. It's about my height, black.
I seem to remember a job lot of junk in there.
Wolf, do you really think we're gonna find the mirror here? I think we should get back to town.
Remember that story of Snow White when she swallowed the poison apple and everyone thought she was dead?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the 7 dwarfs, they brought her here and put her in a glass coffin
here?
In the hopes that someone might be able to bring her back to
in
life.
In this town?
To the top of this very hill. The prince's grandmother.
Oh, my God, look. Is this the real glass coffin? I don't know what it is. I just feel so good.
You will do. Everyone does in the kissing town.
Excuse me.
That's it. Shh, don't attract attention.
Look at that, only 10 to 15 gold coins. It's priced really low. Nobody knows what it is.
Don't turn it on in here, you moron. Everyone will see.
What do you think?
Oh, what, this? Oh, no,
No, I wouldn't even waste my time. It's just a piece of junk.
At first, I thought it was a reproduction. Late Naked Emperor, at best. But I think it's older than that. Quite a lot older. Maybe even early Cinderella. And quite a lot more special.
Right. So, Missy White is lying here for years, and everyone thinks she's dead. Close your eyes. And slow down your breathing so your chest is almost not moving at all. That's nice. And all these handsome chaps come along and try to bring her around, but none of them were good enough for her. You know what I mean? And then one day, this drop-dead, gorgeous prince comes past. And he stops and thinks, oh, what a quirky girl. What a sweetie pie. But she's frozen, cold. She resists his every call with her frozen countenance. And he realizes the only way he can melt this ice queen is to massage the life back into her soft, creamy lips. With a kiss.
Hey! Hey! You two stop clowning around. Found the mirror.
Come on.
Right here, it's gone. It's gone. Hey, wait! Hey! The mirror that was here. Where is it?
Well, you mean the magic mirror? What a find! We're all tremendously excited about it. Oh. It's in there.
Erase that.